Hi friends, this is Anil Raj. Welcome to Wits Connect. In today's topic, we are going to discuss about Kennedy's SILT theory. So, number of scientists proposed SILT theories, but Kennedy is the first person who proposed SILT theory. According to him, we'll call it as Kennedy's SILT theory. And this is very useful topic in irrigation. So, who is Kennedy? Kennedy is an executive engineer who have done several experiments on SILT theories. So he has taken a channel from Punjab, so that is Upper Bari Doab. Upper Bari Doab channel, and this channel he has taken it for his SILT proposal theories, and this is located in Punjab. And now this presently it is in Pakistan. So he proposed his SILT theory in the year of 1865. In 1865 he proposed his theory, SILT theory in 1865, and he have gone through this Upper Bari Doab canals. So according to him, what he has given is that actually he have seen this, actually this site, and this site is not desilting, it is non-scouring and non-silting channel. So according to him, up to 30 years there was no silting and scouring, because it's a unlined channel. In this unlined channels also there was no silting and no scouring, and he was very shocked by seeing this, and he have taken some of his research proposals from this, and he started doing a research on this, and he's proposed his SILT theory. So according to him, so actually we will be having a channel sections, right? So these are the channel sections, which are unlined channel section. We'll call them as unlined channel section. Lining, in the sense you have to provide lining in between these. These are unlined channel sections. So when the water is flowing in these unlined channel sections, so water generally carries a lot of velocity. So due to this velocity, when the water is flowing, what happens, in the sense, it will erode the bed. So here what happens, eddies are going to be formed. We'll call it as eddies. Eddies are going to be formed. When the water hits forcefully to the ground, eddies are going to be formed. These eddies will carry silt, and it will try to float on the top of the water. So this silt is going to be float on the top of the water. So this is developed due to the frictional force. And here you may get a doubt, why only the vertical one, the slope is also, the eddies will also get from the side slopes also. Of course, from the sides also the eddies are going to be formed, but here the silt carrying power is more in vertical ones rather than the horizontal ones. Eddies are going to be from the horizontal, but there is no case of power to carry the silt for these horizontal ones. So according to him, he gave his theory, that is V naught equal to C due to power of n is a formula where V naught is equal to critical velocity, C is constant, where D is the depth of water, and N is the index number. According to him, V naught equal to C due to the power of N, where V naught equal to critical velocity, but later on he realized that this will be useful only for sandy silt soils. So later on he realized that it should valid for all the type of soils. Then he modified his formula, that is V naught is equal to Cm d to the power of n. So he proposed this critical velocity formula, where here m equal to critical velocity ratio. So here v naught is equal to c, can be given as 0.55 into m into d to power of 0.64. So this is the formula. This is the formula for finding out the critical velocities. Here m is taken as, m is equal to v by v naught, where v is the actual velocity, v naught is the critical velocity. So this is the ratio of CVR. So here, like this, you have to find out the critical velocities. So he proposed his theory and his designs. So let us see the design procedure of Kennedy-Seale theory.